President Kennedy, our beloved president, was killed.
The president of the United States is dead.
The youth culture in America turned to the establishment and asked this very profound question. Why didn't you protect him?
There was kind of a gloom that settled over the country.
Just honestly, an avalanche of kids from all over the world that came to Sunset Strip. And they basically would close the street down on the weekends. You couldn't drive on Sunset Strip. It was just like a love-in down there.
From Crescent Heights to Doheny was just full of people walking. So the merchants, I think they looked like Halloween. Everybody was dressed up with hippie clothes, hanging in coffee shops with very little money, you know, hogging tables.
And they complained to the city council, and the cops started parking a big bus, asking everybody for ID and arresting all kinds of underage kids.
It was not unusual to go down to Sunset Boulevard and see 500 kids with their arms against the wall being frisked. Basically, it was open season on hippies.
Anyone under the age of 18 years old remaining in the area will be arrested.
The mounting tensions of a 10 p.m. curfew combined with police harassment and the closing of the popular nightclub Pandora's Box culminated in a November 12, 1966 protest that turned violent.
I remember sitting by the pool once, and Stephen Stills came by, and he says, I want to play you this new song I'm working on, and he played For What It's Worth on the guitar, just sitting by the pool.
Something happening here, but what it is ain't exactly clear.
That was the anthem, because it really did speak to what was going on the street, you know.
Yeah.
And it really was the hippies against the police.
Which was ridiculous, really. Why not just let everybody, mm-hmm. It was very peaceful, you know. Why not let people have a good time and be happy?
In August of 67, the Los Angeles City Council claimed the streets at the intersection of Sunset and Crescent Heights needed to be realigned, and Pandora's Box was demolished. The headlines in the LA Times read, "Hippies pout, politicians cheer."
In Los Angeles, California, the Sunset Strip is peaceful this Sunday morning, the aftermath of a terrifying night. Once this glittering street that winds through 2.5 miles of America's most expensive real estate was a meeting place of movie stars, politicians, and business tycoons. World-famous restaurants and nightclubs such as Ciro's, the Crescendo, and the Plymouth House were crammed with tourists and natives who hoped to catch a glimpse of Gary Cooper, Marilyn Monroe, or even Clark Gable. These names, these places, are now gone. They have been replaced by the long-haired, the unwashed, the rebellious. This building was once the Los Angeles Conservatory of Music. It is now the Whiskey a Go-Go. This used to be an exclusive night spot called the Golden Violin, where diners were serenaded by soft violins. It has now been changed by the same owner into the Galaxy, an 18 and over Watusi Palace. The Sunset Strip is filled with names like The Door, Iron Butterfly, Loving Spoonful, and Smokestack Lightning.
Rebellious kids who are drug addicts, and they're drug addicts. Another thing, they're dirty and they don't bathe. Still another thing is, look, they wear this long hair, and that awful colorful clothes, they must be homosexual.
The Sheriff's Department is concerned where there is conflict between segments of our community. Our code of ethics reads in part, as a law enforcement officer, my fundamental duty is to serve mankind, to safeguard lives and property, to protect the innocent against deception, the weak against oppression or intimidation, and the peaceful against violence or disorder, to respect the constitutional rights of all men to liberty, This code of ethics must be applied to all people regardless of their race, color, creed, or in this case, the length of hair or mode of dress.
We're trying to get the support of the people of Los Angeles. We're trying to make them understand that we're their children and we're the future citizens of this city, and that they really shouldn't allow their police force, who are supposed to be their servants and our servants, to molest us and beat us up.
Something happening here, but what it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there, telling me I got to beware. I think it's time we stop, children, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. Being drawn, nobody's right if everybody's wrong. Young people speak in their minds are getting so much resistance from behind. Time we stop, hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. A few cold day for the heat. A thousand people in the street, singing songs and a carrying signs, mostly say hooray for our side. It's time we stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. Paranoia strikes deep into your life, it will creep. It starts when you're always afraid. Step out of line, the man come and take you away. We better stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going on. We better stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going on. We better stop now. What's that sound? Everybody look what's going on.
To the Los Angeles taxpayers, $257,000. Damage and personal property destroyed, $1,338,000. More than 8% of those arrested were under 21. Three quarters of those were less than 16. Parents protested vigorously about alleged police brutality. Most of these stated that their children were innocent bystanders and should not have been arrested. Some parents bitterly denied that their children were even there, even after the police had awakened them in the middle of the night to notify them that their children were in police custody. 5 hours later, official statements were issued. The ride was now.
When you're a stranger, when you're a stranger, faces look ugly. When you're alone, women seem wicked. When you're unwanted, streets are uneven. When you're gone, people are strange. When you're a stranger, faces look ugly. When you're alone, women seem wicked. Lonely and wretched, streets are lonely. When you're gone, when you're strange, faces come out of the rain. When you're strange, no one remembers your name. When you're strange, when you're strange, when you're strange.
When you're strange, all right, yeah. teenage nightclub. Protesters over the 10 o'clock curfew, Vietnam, the racial issue, fanned the flames of the already excited listeners. The mob became more and more agitated. Traffic began to slow down on the strip as people began to clog the street. A rally began, and the scattered clusters merged to a central meeting place in front of Pandora's Box.
Love my girl. She looking good. Come on. One more.
5-1, baby. 1 in 5. No one here gets out alive now. You get yours, baby. I'll get mine. Gonna make it, baby, if we try.
Regular programming.
The LAPD
you can get it then either, you know? It's like they decided to run a lineup across the street like there was some kind of a revolution going on or something, you know? And it's a bunch of kids having a funeral for a bar.
I got busted by the cops. Remember when they took me down to the Sunset and Clark, you know, down there the police station was? Took me inside, you know, and then started me and this other guy, Freddie Brechtel. I don't know if you remember
his name. I remember that name. Yeah. My God.
So we were in the cell, and they were calling us names and everything, and the cop was calling us. The one cop had real short hair, like sticking up, you know, like in a brush cut with big horn-rimmed glasses, and he called me an animal, you know. So I called him a grasshopper.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Oh, God. Uh-oh. So they came in and knocked my tooth out, this one right here, and did this other stuff and banged us around. It happened really fast. I didn't put up much of a fight, obviously. And but that was, you know, just that was kind of like the ambience, you know.
That
we
was
were freaks. In a pretty cool car, and bang, in jail, you know, for whatever, who knows.